What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do?
I think without a doubt, compassion has one of the most compelling messages in all of the world. And certainly within the context of the kingdom of God, what we talk about, what we have to say about what we do is so important. The message is important. We haven't always told it very well. I've been around long enough to see us do this pretty poorly a few times. I remember back when I was director of development, back in the mid-80s, we had a very novel idea. Let's have a couple of young guys walk across the United States with a llama to get attention and let them go along the way and tell their story, you know, town after town after town. We'll raise sponsors, we'll get into the news. One of the kids that was doing the walk-ins, father was one of the big national anchors on national news. This was my big idea. This was really gonna work. We had the mayor of Colorado Springs come for the official send-off. Big fancy words of prayer, and we sent them off with chariots of fire music. Oh, my tears were streaming down our face. They barely got out of sight before they started fighting with each other. They didn't get out of Colorado. You and I could have walked it in a weekend. They got to the point where they were fighting so much they couldn't even walk together. They wouldn't stay together, they wouldn't eat together. The whole thing dumped. And we thought, okay, that's the last time we try something that creative and that crazy with our message. A week later, a guy comes and calls and says, I got an idea. My name is Bozo the Clown, and I will row the Mississippi River in a canoe for you. And I think what I'll do is I'll talk in towns along the way. And we said, excuse me, but no. We make mistakes, but we rarely make the same mistake twice. You know how we got rid of him? We said, we have an idea. How about not down the Mississippi, but up the Mississippi? And he says, you know what? I'll call you back. He didn't want to go up against the current. Well, we have tried a lot of stuff, ways to tell our story. We've gotten some really bad advice along the way. One of the worst times was when we hired some very professional consultants to study everything that we have ever written, to go and see the work that we do, and help us with our mastering our message, grow this organization. And they studied us all. They did dozens and dozens of interviews. Then they sat us down, the marketing team, and they says, here's what we got for you. Number one, you've got the best name in the business. Compassion. There's not another organization with a better name. Who doesn't want to be a part of something called Compassion? But you got this Jesus stuff going as well. And not everybody who cares about compassion cares about Jesus. And so while you got a powerful name, you are driving people away with the Jesus part. So here's our advice. Lift up the compassion, downplay the Jesus, and my goodness, there's no end to the potential in your marketing efforts. We listened to that report, and then we got together, and we pondered and pondered and pondered for, I don't know, 10 seconds, and we said, no, not only not now, but never. We will not let this organization go down that road. And so we committed ourselves that it would be always in our message, always about Jesus Christ. And that's where we changed our bylaws. That's where we changed our mission statement in response to the Great Commission. That's where the in Jesus name, releasing children from poverty in Jesus name came out of. We changed the sign on the front yard. We launched our ambassadors to the future so that it doesn't even wilt away in 50 years. A few years later, we brought Jesus right into the middle of our lobby. One of the first things you see when you walk in is Jesus. I can tell you this, if you look at the growth curve of compassion over those years, when we made that decision that we were going to honor Christ, that we were going to stay centered on Jesus, the growth just absolutely took off. That was in the mid-80s. We're six or seven times the size we were back then. Sadly, now, these days, I've watched other organizations get the very same advice. And not only have they not honed in on Jesus, they've taken the word Christian right out of their name. The others that are on the fence and not sure what to do. Well, what are we going to do? We're going to stay the course. We are going to tell our story as exciting and wonderfully dynamic and strategic as it is. But we will never tell it without always focusing in on Jesus Christ, who is the center of this ministry, who is the Lord of our lives, the Lord of our universe. It's all about Jesus, and it always will be. you going to do?